you come here expecting God to do great things? Amen. I went to Bible school, and up there on the wall they have expect God to do great things and attempt great things for God. Amen. I believe that's a good motto we could have in our life.
Tell you what, the world can bog you down if you let it. You keep your focus on the world and the things going on. I know we're kind of in it, you know. But we can keep our eyes on Jesus. He can help us through it all. And I thank the Lord for that.
Daniel, when I thought about the three Hebrew boys when they were in the fiery furnace, their friend was with them. And our friend was on the cross, bearing our sins. And
I want to go on. Focusing on getting close to the Lord, and He has been showing me so many things in myself that I can do better in, and I'm just so thankful, and I just want to go on serving.
Thank you, Jesus, for the blood bought. Thank you, Jesus, it has washed me white.
I mean, even praying down there, somebody came behind me and touched me and said exactly what I was going through. They were like, help her with this, and they don't even know. Like, you can't tell me that's not God, and I'm just so thankful that He takes the time to reassure you.
There's a lot of people in this world. Life's real dark. I really don't understand how a lot of people get by without hope, and I don't understand what gives them hope. I mean, what if this life is the only thing? You know, for us Christians, Paul says it would be a life of most miserable. Yeah. But how about for those people who they don't even have a God that walks with them? You know, let's say this is just this the only time. You know, we only get 70 years down here. Well, what about the Lord who walks with us those 70 years? That'd be enough for me.
I felt like I could not possibly make it without coming to church on Sundays and every week, because I need God's people and I need His house. And I felt the reassurance to go ahead and look for another job, and I found one within a week, and I know that's just God. I'm very thankful.
Assurance, Jesus is mine. He's been my boatman in the fire, time after time.
But see, there came a night where I was standing right there. And I kind of threw my hands up in the air, and then I just kind of dropped them, and I was just going to go sit back down in my pew. And then Brother Justin Bond waved me forward, and he waved me up to the altar, and I walked up there. And then I knew for myself that if I didn't get an experience, if I didn't get the Holy Ghost, I wasn't going to last. I knew that in that moment, I believe if I hadn't got the Holy Ghost that night, I would either be in the world or I'd be burning in hell right now. But see, when I started seeking the Lord and I started seeking His presence, He answered that night. And I can't tell you what happened. I can't tell you the exact day. I can't tell you what they were singing. I can't tell you if there was a sermon. All I know is that I went up there stressed out, worried, consumed with things that I shouldn't have been consumed by. And the next thing I can remember is I was laying on that floor speaking in a heavenly language, and I have learned to trust Him ever since. And He has never failed me. He has never let me down. He has given me a reason that I can trust Him and I can depend on Him.
Sister Marley's been saved 5 years, and you got 1, 2, 3, 4
members of your family.
5, 6, anybody else? That's why I trust Him. That's why I believe in Him, Brother Eddie. Because Sister Marley came and got saved and gave her heart to God and started loving the Lord and started coming to church. She's got a family that now come to church with her, Brother Terry. That's why I trust in God. You say, well, I don't know what I'm... Put your trust in Jesus.
I can't go back to the way it used to be before your presence came and changed me.
Oh, it changed me.
I won't go back. I can't go back.
I know King Nebuchadnezzar is pretty strong.
But I'm just going to tell you, he ain't got a hold of you. He ain't got a hold of you. You got a hold of him. You're holding on to him. And I'm telling you, as long as you hold on to him, you're giving him strength. You know what you need to do? Let it go. Let it go and move on over to the promised land. Hallelujah. That's what you got to do. Hey man, listen, that never is not too hard for you to drop it. Drop it. I said, let it go.